Are the Lightning a better hockey team than they were a week ago? You don't need me to tell you, they aren't. But Steve Yzerman gets paid to think past tonight, into next month, next year, and beyond. The Bolts GM made more shrewd moves at today's trade deadline, but the players, they've got to play. The Lightning hosting the Hurricanes in a clash of weather phenomena. Tampa Bay was outshot 18-4 in the first and trailed 2-1 in the third when Johnny Hockey knots it up. Tyler Johnson deflects Jake Thatchin's slapper, and it's two apiece. Then with under five to go, Johnson sauces a pass to Nikita Kucherov, and he's got softer hands than Keith Kate. Sorry, buddy. 5 goals, 12 points in 4 games for Cooch. But moments later, Canes are shorthanded. Jacob Slavin shoots. Jay McClement tips it home. And it's tied up again with 2:30 left. So how about some overtime? Free hockey. Kucherov and Hedman get open ice. And Heddy makes no mistake about it. His second goal of the night is the game winner. Tampa Bay takes it 4-3 and has earned points in 9 of its last 10 games.
Tonight, I don't know if I can sit here and say that for 100% we should have got those 2 points, but luckily for us, we were able to get it.
We've played a lot of games in the last month and a half where we felt we deserved a better fate and didn't get it, and tonight was probably one where maybe it was just reversed a little bit, but we got points.
Centerman Valtteri Filppula practiced at Amalie Arena this morning and even signed autographs afterwards. Those were his final moments as a member of the Lightning. Just before today's deadline, Filppula was traded to Philadelphia along with 4th and 7th round draft picks in exchange for defenseman Mark Streit. General manager Steve Yzerman then flipped Streit to the Penguins for a 2018 fourth rounder, essentially clearing $5 million in salary next season at the cost of a 7th round selection.
I've got to make decisions on based on our record. And if our record is different, we would potentially make different decisions. But these particular ones had to be made at some point. Our record dictated that we had to make them now.
If someone offered you $7 million a year to be Jameis Winston's backup quarterback, how fast would you sign the dotted line? If you're Mike Glennon, not so fast. The Buccaneers have reportedly offered to make Glennon the highest paid QB2 in the league, but he's still expected to test the waters of free agency, much to the chagrin of general manager Jason Light.
We'd love to have Mike back in a perfect scenario. It's going to depend on, I think for him, he's going to have some opportunities, where it is, how good of a chance he has to start there, but we'd love to have him back.
The entire production crew was like, how fast? Yeah. Now, right. Give me the contact. I also want to mention the Rays tied the Phillies 5-5 today. They play the Sox tomorrow at 1.
All right, sounds good. Thanks. Soft hand.
It's a mark of the business, Keith.
How did you know? We'll be right back with your winning lotto numbers.